happy is the mother who bore you and nursed you?
Rather, how happy are those who hear the word of God and obey it?
Teach us to pray, just as John taught his disciples.
When you pray, say, Our Father in heaven, holy be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us day by day our daily bread. And forgive us our sins, for we also forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
In the Holy Scriptures, God declared the Messiah would come to be the Savior of the world. The life of Jesus gives evidence that he is indeed the one the prophets spoke about. Isaiah prophesied that the virgin will conceive a child and will give birth to a son. Centuries later, the birth of Jesus was the fulfillment of that prophecy. The Holy Scriptures declared that the Holy One to be born would be called the Son of God. This means that Jesus was to be called the Son of God in a spiritual sense. We see this in how he lived his life. He healed people from disease, forgave their sins, turned them back to God, and promised them a place in God's eternal kingdom. He offered himself as a sacrifice for sin in their place, and then rose again, conquering death. Jesus said, "No one can take my life from me. I lay it down of my own accord." The life of Jesus not only fulfilled the writings of the prophets, but also confirmed the truth of God's holy word. The prophets declared, "The word of the Lord is flawless. Your word, O Lord, is eternal." Jesus himself said, "Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will never pass away." Jesus came to give us life in all its fullness. But when man disobeyed God in the Garden of Eden, he chose to go his own way, and his actions separated him from the Creator. The Holy Scriptures declare that all have sinned, and the payment for sin is death. This means a spiritual death, eternal separation from God. But just as God provided a ram to die in place of Abraham's son, so he sent Jesus the Messiah to die in our place. His life, death, and resurrection restored the relationship between God and all those who put their trust in him. Now, those who follow Jesus not only have their sins forgiven, but are saved from God's eternal judgment. They are assured of paradise and will live with him forever. It is this life and freedom from the guilt and power of sin that Jesus offers each person today. This does not mean following a religion, but choosing to have faith in Jesus, who says, "I stand at the door and knock. If anyone hears my voice and opens the door, I will come into him." This means turning to God and trusting Jesus to come into our lives, to forgive our sins, and to make us what he wants us to be. It is not enough to intellectually agree with his claims, nor to have an emotional experience. We receive him by grace through faith as an act of the will. When people are ready to become followers of Jesus the Messiah, they may speak to him in a simple prayer. Perhaps you are ready now to open your life to God. If so, you may join in the following prayer to him, silently, in your heart. Lord Jesus, I need you. Thank you for dying on the cross for my sins. I confess and repent of my sins. I open the door of my life and receive you as my Savior and Lord. Thank you for forgiving my sins and giving me eternal life. Make me the kind of person you want me to be. As I become one of your followers. Amen. Jesus said about his followers, "My sheep recognize my voice. I know them, and they follow me." In order to experience the abundant life which Jesus promised, his followers talk to God each day in prayer and read or listen to his word. They tell others about him and meet regularly with those who love and follow him. Remember his wonderful promise. All power is given to me in heaven and in earth. Lo, I am with you always, even to the end of the world.
Panjenengan sak menika Gusti.
Rahayu ibu ingkang garbeni sono sepi paduka.
Luwe rahayu wong kang krungu pangantikaning Allah lan gatekake.
Mucal kawulon ndedonga, kados Nabi Yohanan mucal sekabatipun.
Menawa kowe ndedonga munjuk omang kene, duh Rama kawula wonten ing swarga. Asma paduka kasucikna. Kraton paduka rawuh, karso paduka kalampahana ing bumi kados dene ing swarga. Kawula kaparing ana rejeki ing saben dintenipun. Saha dosa kawula kaapunten kados dene kawula ngapunten tiyang ingkang kalepatan dhateng kawula. Sarta sampun katandukaken ing panggudha nanging kauwalna saking piyawon.
Ono ing kitab suci, Allah ngendika yen Almasih bakal rawuh pinangka juru slameting donya. Lelakon uripe Isa bukti yen panjenengane iku salah sawijining wong kang diwartakake para nabi. Nabi Yesaya menehi weruh menawa ana kenya kang bakal ngandhut lan nglairake jabang bayi. Pirang-pirang abad sakwise Isa lahir, mujudake apa sing wis diramalke sadurunge. Kitab suci nyatakake menawa sing dilairke kanthi suci iku bakal kasebut putraning Allah. Iku tegese Isa bakal kasebut putra Allah ing sajroning pangerten rohani. Kita kabeh nyekseni kasunyatan iki liwat lelakon uripe Isa. Isa nyarasake wong loro, ngapurani sak kabeh ing dosa, lan janjekake sawijining panggonan ana ing kraton dalem Allah kang langgeng. Isa nyerahake ragane pinangka panebuse dosa lan wungu saka sedo. Kabeh mau wis jumbuh karo rencanane Allah. Isa ngandika, "Sapa wae ora bakal ana sing iso njupuk uripku saka aku. Aku menehake miturut karepku dhewe." Lelakon uripe Isa ora mung genepi tulisane para nabi, nanging uga neguhake yen firman Allah iku suci. Para nabi nyatakake, firman dalem Gusti iku sampurno. Firman panjenengane langgeng duh Gusti. Isa dhewe ngendika, "Langit lan bumi bakal sirna, nanging sing tak ucapake ora bakal sirna." Isa rawuh saperlu maringi urip kang kaluberan, nanging nalika manungsa orang gugu kersane Allah ing Taman Eden, iku ateges manungsa milih dalane dhewe, lan tumindake iku misahake manungsa karo sing nitahake. Miturut kitab suci, kabeh manungsa wis tumindak dosa, lan opahe dosa yaiku pati. Yaiku mati kanthi cara rohani ateges pisah saka Allah saklawase. Nanging kaya dene Allah nyediakake wedhus lanang kanggo ganti anake Abraham, semono uga panjenengane ngirim Isa Sang Almasih sedo kanggo kita. Urip sedo lan wungune mulihake hubungane antarane Allah karo sakabehe manungsa kang percaya marang panjenengane. Saiki sapa wae sing nderek Isa ora mung diapura dosane, nanging uga kaslametake saka hukuman Allah kang langgeng. Kabeh manungsa kajamin mlebu swarga lan manggon karo panjenengane saklawase. Ya urip iki sarta bebase manungsa saka kesalahan lan dosa kang ditawakake Isa marang sakabehe wong saiki uga. Tawaran iki ora ateges nganut sawijining agama, nanging milih lan percaya marang Isa sing ngendika, "Aku ngadeg ing ngarep lawang lan ndodhok. Yen ana wong sing krungu swaraku banjur mbukakake, aku arep mlebu lan nemoni dheweke." Iku tegese balik marang Allah lan percaya yen Isa bakal lumebu ing sajroning urip kita, ngapurani dosa-dosa lan dadekake kita pribadi kang dikersakake. Kanggo mangerteni Isa ora mung cukup nganggo akal utawa emosi. Kita nampa Isa ada dasar kasih kurnia liwat pangandel lan kekarepan. Nalika manungsa sumadyo dadi pendereke Isa Almasih, mula kabeh banjur iso matur marang panjenengane sarana donga sing sederhana. Saiki mungkin para sedulur wis sumadyo miwiti urip ing ngarsane Allah. Yen pancen mengkono, tirokno donga iki ing sajroning atimu. Gusti, kawula mbetahaken panjenengan. Matur nuwun panjenengan sampun kersa sedo ing kayu salib kangge nebus dosa-dosa kawula. Kawula ngaken lan maratobat saking dosa-dosa kawula. Kanthi saklebeting manah, kawula nampi panjenengan dados juru slamet lan Gusti kawula. Matur nuwun panjenengan sampun kersa ngapunten dosa-dosa kawula lan maringi gesang langgeng. Dadosno kawula pribadi miturut kersa panjenengan. Nalika kawula dados penderek panjenengan. Amin. Isa ngendika marang pendereke, "Domba-dombaku ngrungokake swaraku, aku ngenal sakabehe lan sakabehe melu aku." Kanggo urip kang kaluberan kaya sing dijanjekake Isa, mula saben dina para pendereke matur marang Allah sarana donga lan maca firmane. Kabeh padha nyritakake bab Allah marang wong liya, banjur dadi sedulur ambek kabeh wong kang ngasihi lan nderek panjenengane. Tansah elinga tumrap janjine kang endah. Marang aku wis diparingake sakabehing kuwasa ing swarga lan bumi. Ngertiyo, aku tansah nunggil karo kowe kabeh nganti tumekaning akhir jaman.